My father's biography is pretty straightforward. He's a mathematician. He became good at math pretty early on. He emigrated from Russia to the U.S. at the age of 28, where he got almost immediately a full-time professorship at Harvard University, where he was for 30-some-odd years. And then my father and my mother made Aliyah about 10 years ago, and since then he's been a professor of math at Hebrew University. He's an avid mathematician, he's an avid hiker, an avid Talmud scholar, he's an avid biker, and we've been going out biking fairly regularly. That particular morning was a little bit more challenging than usual. He was about 20, 30 feet behind me, and then all of a sudden I heard some sort of a noise, which didn't sound particularly good, and I turned around and I saw him sprawled on the ground. He was run over by a very large wheel of a very large truck, which was a double tractor trailer, and it seems that the wheel basically went over him. The emergency services came. When I asked them, where's he going to? And then, you know, they said, the person in this condition is the only one place he's going, that's Hadassah Hospital.
Professor Kazhdan came to the trauma unit, unconscious, intubated. From outside you could see that his pelvis is totally not in place. The legs had severe degloving injury, and he bled. From the very beginning, we had this problem of bleeding with Professor Kazhdan. We gave him a lot of blood, fresh frozen plasma, platelets, thrombocytes, fibrinogen. Professor Kazhdan was very, very close to death. From our previous experience, although the FDA and the company is not allowing to use the Novo 7 drug, they took it out from the shelf for treating trauma patients. We gave Professor Kazhdan 2 vials of Novo 7. And you cannot argue with success. He stopped bleeding. I can say very modestly that in every center in the world, Professor Kazhdan would not survive the first 24 hours.
The tower is an amazing place. It's a place that you can almost have a normal life. Leave aside the patient himself is on a beautiful bed in a sterile conditions, everything is beautiful. But people who come visit, you want to come visit the patient.
The new ORs in the Davidson Tower will be state of the art.
Hadassah has incredibly good staff of nurses. I expected doctors to be very good, and they are. I never had seen such wonderful nurses.
Professor David Kazhdan came to our department when he was totally disabled, and the orthopedic surgeons decided not to operate him and let him undergo rehabilitation without fixation of his fractures. It was a real challenge for us. But his personality, despite this disaster, he was always optimistic and very, very strong. His wife was amazing. I heard from her, our pain, our leg, our wound, this couple, they became total one. Progress was huge.
I think that, you know, when you look at the history of Hadassah Hospital and the donations of the Hadassah organization to the hospital throughout the years, that's a partnership. I mean, that's a real partnership that, you know, I, as a Jerusalemite, I see the fruits of it. It's one of the top medical centers, not only in Israel and worldwide.
I feel proud and happy. He is walking. You look at him, you look, you know, to the sky. It gives you, you know, fuel to another 20 years to walk.